How to calculate OEE quickly, effectively, and efficiently. In my experience, I have seen a lot of time and resources wasted many times in calculating the OEE of the wrong machines. Other times I have seen engineers spend time in spreadsheets to evaluate the OEE with unnecessary precision. Taiichi Ohno claimed, "Data is of course important in manufacturing, but I place the greatest emphasis on facts. So, what's the point of knowing the OEE of all the company's machines, data, if there is no real increase in sales, facts?" In this video, I will explain my method to calculate the OEE in a fast way so you can avoid spending too much time and resources doing calculations that nobody will benefit from. This method is quite good for single machines in production cells and not very good for long, automated production lines. Step 1. Before OEE, you have to know problem solving. OEE is a problem solving tool and not a calculation for its own sake. Before starting with the OEE calculation, make sure you have the appropriate knowledge of problem solving techniques. Step 2. In the beginning, choose only one or two machines on which to calculate the OEE. I have often seen companies start with the OEE calculation on all the machines in the company, with inadequate or excessive use of resources. When resources were inadequate, the calculation was inaccurate and therefore useless. When resources were excessive, calculating the OEE of 50 machines became a numerical exercise that lost its meaning. My method involves starting with the most important product family, making it the value stream map, and with the team, making a first hypothesis of the one or two constraints or bottleneck machines. Step 3. Listen to the people working on the chosen machines. Arrange interviews with the people who work on the chosen machines daily. Empathize with them and tell them that you want to take the machine to peak performance. Ask simple questions such as, does the machine break down often? Does the machine produce defective parts? Do you take a long time to do the setups? What bores you about working on this machine? Record responses in an orderly manner. Step 4. Observe the machine at different times of the week. Taiichi Ohno strongly believed in observation as the first step of improvement. So, for a week or two, go and observe your chosen machines for 1 or 2 hours. See if the machine breaks down, if there are micro stops, if the machine is working, if the machine is waiting for parts, etc. After these observations of yours, check that they are congruent with the interview answers. Step 5. Make an assumption of the value of the OEE. At this point, you have many elements to hypothesize a range of possible OEE values. My rule of thumb is, disastrous machine equals OEE between 10%-20%. Machine on average working equals OEE between 20%-30%. Machine working equals OEE between 30%-40%. It is only the first hypothesis. Rarely do machines that have not undergone a serious improvement program have an OEE greater than 50%. Step 6. Organize the daily lean morning meeting near the machine. Every morning, meet with the work team to discuss the operation of the machine for the previous 24 hours. If you don't know what the lean morning meeting is, watch the videos that I leave links to in the description. You are only now beginning to collect performance, availability, and quality data in a timely manner. Remember to also record the daily machine output and the daily finished product output of the value stream you are watching. Step 7. Start immediately with the obvious improvements. There is no need to wait for too much data to do a fives event, fix leaking pipes, or make sure there are always operators available. Get started with these Kaizen. Step 8. Refine the OEE calculation, but don't use the microscope. At this point, you should have data and elements to evaluate which of the three components of the OEE. The purpose of this step is to understand which contribution lowers the OEE value the most. For example, if after a few weeks you have these data, availability equals 85%, performance equals 70%, quality equals 95%, O equals 56%. It is clear to you that you must work on performance as a priority to raise the OEE. Would it change the sense if the performance were 71% instead of 70%? Step 9. The facts. The moment of verification. If after a few weeks, the OEE has improved but the product output has not improved comparably, then either the machine is not the constraint of the value stream or the calculations are wrong. If instead, the improvement of the OEE corresponds to an increase in the output of the product, it means that you have selected the right machine and you have understood the power of the OEE calculation. Step 10. Repeat or expand. Looking at the results of Step 9, you can easily understand whether to move to another machine in the value stream or expand the methodology to the company's second product family. My advice is not to expand the methodology until you have fully understood it and with tangible results. Mistakes to avoid. 1. Spending money to automate the OEE calculation without fully understanding it. 2. Not having adequate resources to support the calculation on the number of machines selected. 3. Calculating the OEE with 0.01% accuracy when not needed. Conclusions. The OEE calculation is a problem-solving tool with a specific focus on machines. The OEE needs to be calculated to identify the major causes of loss of efficiency and remedy them. There is no need to waste time and resources on the wrong machines and with unnecessarily precise calculations. Improving the OEE must have a tangible impact on sales, otherwise it's just a numerical exercise. Thanks for watching the video, and please remember to subscribe to the channel. You can find more info in the description below.